Hello. Today I'd like to share with you my trickle-down painting and to demonstrate how to make woven collage. Here are some pieces of woven collage. As you can see, they are dramatic, colourful reliefs and sculptural forms, both abstract and figurative. You can use a wide range of thinned paints and inks to do trickle-down painting. The important thing is that it must flow like drawing ink. You can use acrylic drawing inks like these. You can use any acrylic paint, as long as you thin it down. You can thin down even really thick acrylic paint with things like airbrush medium or flow improver, which you can buy, but you could also use ionized water, that's distilled water. You can use surgical spirits. A mixture of these works well. You can use a tiny drop of washing up liquid, which actually breaks the surface tension of the paint and makes it easier to flow. It's all a matter of experimentation and trial and error. The airbrush mediums and the flow improvers that are manufactured by artist paint manufacturers will maintain the qualities of the paint, whereas some of the other things might need the surface to be deteriorated. But it's all a matter of experimentation. I'm going to start by painting in some stripes of background colours. They don't have to be perfect because the textures of where you haven't cut the paper fully will just add the collage that you make in the end. So remember, it's just about mixing colours and enjoying the mixtures and the juxtaposition of colours. I'm going to cover the whole of the card, apart from perhaps one strip, which I will leave white, so that the colours that we trickle down later on will actually stand out even more. Here's a stripe of blue, beautiful, rich oil blue. Stripe of lovely signal red. Picking up a little bit of blue accidentally, but it's all part of the mixing of colours. It will all enhance your collage in the end. Here's a nice dark metallic turquoisey colour. This has got a bit of a metallic in it. That'll come out lovely. I'm going to start doing the trickle down painting on some of this background colour that's still wet, because that will make for very interesting mixtures of colours. I'm using these cheap plastic pipettes to drop in the colours. I've got one in each pot of colour. Here we go, while the paint is still wet, I'm going to start to put in some blue on this yellow. And you can see
it's still wet. So it's mixing as it goes. I'm going to use a paper straw to blow the colour, just to speed it up a bit. And I'm going to blow some of it back the other way so it doesn't come off the end. As it dries, it will make a very pleasing colour. Now I'm going to run some of this pearlescent pink down these blue corrugations. And I'll put some in from the other end now. Remember, they're still slightly wet. Rather a lot. Do one more. A little purple in this on this pink background. May look quite a mess, but when it's all cut up, it'll be all part of the glorious pattern. Here up, I'll blow some more purple down over this pink. And a little yellow on the blue background, which still isn't dry. The way this dries makes textures rather like lichen or rust or oxidizing metals. It's very pleasing. Here's some more yellow on the slightly wet blue background. And a little green. As you can see, now I've got a wide array of beautiful colours and textures and patterns. They're all ready to be cut up. I've also got some metallic paint that I've put colour on too. Cutting the corrugations is quite tricky, so it's easier to cut the whole sheet in half before you cut them, and that will make it easier. You can cut them in pairs of corrugations, or pairs of flutes, That's certainly easier than cutting individual ones. Cutting an individual one is quite tricky and a little bit hit and miss. So you'll probably waste quite a few bits. But certainly pears are much easier. And also give you a wider array of colour. After half an hour or so of cutting, I've got a wide variety of flutes that I can start to weave. I find that if I put a black pipe cleaner down the middle of each corrugation, that's threading it in like this. Let's do another one. This helps to hold them in place when I'm weaving them. These are the black pipe cleaners. You could use any colour, but black. I prefer black. I bought them online. Here I've got a wide array of colourful strips, both short and long, and I'm ready to start weaving them. I'm going to start off by making a sheaf pattern, a simple sheaf pattern, and that's going to be about 12 vertical strips and probably 24, 25 horizontal strips. My starting point is to weave 3 horizontals and 4 vertical strips together. Then I'll choose some more horizontals, passing them under and over and pulling them together in the centre. As you can see, the pipe cleaners help to stiffen the weave, and I can lift some up so that it makes it easier. I'm choosing colours that contrast with the colours that are already there. Once I've got quite a few in, I can pull everything in so it's all quite tight. Now I'll start to add some more vertical pieces. Trying to keep the whole thing tight. And some more longer verticals on the other side, lifting up alternate strands to create the weave. Now, in order to make the sheaf and make the ends, the top and the bottom, splay out, I've cut a piece that's tapered towards the inside and goes outwards towards the ends. So I'm going to weave that in now. Now I'll weave in one more thin vertical. There's probably only really room for one more now. This is the last vertical, and and I'm going to use some super glue just to hold it in place. Little tiny drop. Be careful not to get your fingers stuck. Now I will clip off the ends of the pipe cleaners. They're actually quite tough. And continue to work up with the horizontals. Bending the verticals down over the horizontal strands. And pulling up alternate strands before putting down the next horizontal strand. And I'm trying to splay them out to create the sheaf, like a sheaf of corn pattern. I'm going to use a little super glue here because I'm forcing the shape out. And that just helps to keep it in position. As the sheaf splays out towards the bottom and the top, the horizontal strands need to be longer. So you might want to cut down some of the longer vertical strands. Again, getting towards the end, I'm using the super glue more and more, just to keep it in place. Be careful not to get your fingers stuck to the collage. Super glue is tricky stuff. As you can see, it is flaring out now towards the bottom. I might just get one more strand in there. Now this is the last strand on the bottom. I'm using super glue for each piece now because I don't want it to run. Some of the verticals were short and they haven't gone all the way down to the bottom, but that discrepancy actually makes for quite an interesting pattern. It's all very serendipitous. That's all quite well stuck now, and I can trim it when I finish the rest of it. Now going back up to the other end, I'm splaying out the verticals to give me the sheaf pattern. And now I'm going to fold up alternate vertical strands to create my weave. Again, I'm using super glue to stick down the verticals, because I'm forcing the strands outwards to make the sheaf pattern. Again, I'm folding up alternate vertical strands before I lay my horizontal strands across. Again, using a tiny drop of super glue, hold the vertical strands down and keep them in position. Now I'm cutting down some of the longer pieces because my sheaf is spreading out. This is a nice piece of bronzy looking card with a sort of verdigris finish on it. Again, little drops of super glue to hold down the vertical strands. If you move the whole thing around on your work surface, hopefully it won't stick to the work surface. Now everything's stuck down, and all I need to do is trim it. I'm going to leave some of the feathery edges on. Just as you get strands of corn that are come outside the sheaf. With their little feathery edges. Right, so that's it.